Graphics card prices are in a bit of a weird predicament now, where they're not as bad as they were a few months ago, but they still suck. And in this case, if you're in the market to build a gaming PC, or of course, if you've got a PC that just has a really crappy graphics card, say for instance a GT 710, then you may be looking also to upgrade to something with a little bit more power. However, at the moment, in this wild market, I believe there are some graphics cards, especially if you're just looking to game, that offer better value for money than other graphics cards. So let's take a little look and I'll give you guys some tips on buying a used GPU, and still, even though it's a pretty bad market for buying graphics cards, you'll still be able to get some good value for money. Hey bro, are you tired of seeing this annoying activate Windows message? Then if so, today's video sponsor SCD Keys has you covered. For as little as $14 using the coupon code BFTYC, you can get activated today. Works for Windows 11 Pro too. Links in the description below. So over the last couple of days, I've been analyzing the market because I have a used parts hunt coming up later in the month where I'm mainly looking for, you guessed it, used graphics cards. So I like to see what is going to be the best value for money. So if I put together a gaming PC, then someone who buys it is going to be happy for the price performance that they're paying. So this leads us to the first round of graphics cards that I'm going to be recommending. And that is going to fall into the category of essentially what I would call power inefficient graphics cards for crypto miners. Since the crypto miners are mainly targeting newer graphics cards that are much more efficient than the older graphics cards, this leaves the older graphics cards in a position where pretty much the only people buying them are gamers. So take for instance this graphics card in my hand. Even though the heatsink is a little bit bent on the end, I picked this up for an absolute bargain. This is a GTX 760. Now if you look for GTX 7 series cards, I've noticed that GTX 770 and also a GTX 780 and a 750 Ti, there can be some pretty good deals of $100 and under for these types of cards. Even just quickly looking through the market on ebay.com today, I found three different listings where from the photos, the card looked decent and the description said the graphics cards work, and of course, the price was looking pretty good. Take for instance this GTX 750 Ti. They're asking $70 for it. However, as you may or may not know, $70 at least 2 years ago wasn't a great price for a GTX 750 Ti on the used market. It's about 30% over what I was willing to pay back 2 years ago. However, that being said, if you guys have been following my used parts hunt, you'll notice that I've been paying around 20 to 30% more than what I usually pay for graphics cards. And that is essentially what the extra demand from cryptocurrency miners have placed on the graphics card market itself. That is an artificial higher pricing because there's much more demand than just from gamers. And so at this point, you may be sitting in your chair and you're like, well, Brian, if cryptocurrency miners don't really want the GTX 7 series cards, then why are the prices still overinflated compared to what they used to be? And there are two reasons. One of the reasons we're not going to discuss in this video because I've talked about it quite a lot, but another reason is because the gamers that otherwise aren't willing to pay, say for instance, a $500 price tag on an RX 6600 XT, which is already inflated over its $379 MSRP price, they pretty much quit trying to buy those newer cards and then they look for something cheaper, because the people who are willing to pay the money at MSRP for new cards are essentially being priced out of those newer cards, and then they're looking for other options that exist in the market. So our first option that I've presented today is GTX 7 series cards. I'll put all the links in the description below for some searches that you guys can do on eBay, as well as local listings. However, that being said, there are some drawbacks to each of these series of cards that I'm going to be recommending here today. First off, with the GTX 7 series, is that Nvidia is ending driver support for these graphics cards. That means if there's a new game that's say Fortnite 2.0, and it's everyone's playing it and it doesn't have the driver support from Nvidia, the game may not get optimal performance. And in fact, you may get things like stuttering or just generally low performance if a newer game was to be released and you bought one of these older graphics cards. The second risk factor with the GTX 7 series, of course, is its age. It's quite simply an older card. However, in general, before we move on, and this is going to apply to all the used graphics cards that I'm recommending in today's video, is there's two major things that I look out for when buying used graphics cards. The first is oxidization, aka rust. If there's a heavy amount of oxidization on a graphics card, I usually steer clear of that card, especially if the seller is asking around market rates for the card. The second thing is I always make sure that the graphics card can boot up to Windows and install the drivers. For instance, there's a listing on eBay where the person says that the graphics card boots to BIOS. However, in my experience with a card like this, even though it can boot to BIOS, if you install Windows and then you install the drivers, there may be a chance that the card is actually faulty, and after you install the drivers, you get met with a black screen. So if you're buying any used graphics card, I'd first of all look at the graphics card itself, and that is it looking like it's in decent condition, aka not a whole lot of rust on the thing, and also secondly, does it boot to Windows, and can it install the drivers? Now that being said, if you do buy a graphics card off eBay, for example, you do get a very short-term and effective warranty policy, where if the card comes in and it doesn't work properly, at least if they say that it is working in the description and it says it's a working used product, you can generally get your money back if you get the product and it doesn't work pretty much instantly. Then let's move on now to the next round of graphics cards that I'm seeing some very good value for money come up, at least compared to the newer prices, and that is cards like the R9 280. I've seen these cards coming up on eBay for even under $100. Now these cards have a 3GB VRAM buffer that's gonna be absolutely fine for playing a lot of those popular multiplayer titles at 1080p. For instance, I've been playing a bit of Apex Legends lately and I'm really enjoying it, and a card like an R9 280 will do a great job of playing this game and giving you a smooth experience at 1080p. However, the caveats for the R9 200 series and even cards like the R9 380 and 390, the drawback for these is that just like the GTX 7 series, AMD has announced that they drop support for these cards. So if you do come into a newer released, again, Fortnite 2.0 style game that is new to the market, then AMD won't be releasing support for these older graphics cards. Even though they should technically work fine, it's just they won't be getting the performance enhancements that the newer graphics cards will receive. In other words, if you're playing those newer titles, you won't get as good value for money out of your graphics card as buying something that's new. That said though, the newer graphics cards aren't really looking like they're good value for money right now, so even if you found yourself in that position, it would probably still equal out in your favor. However, just going through some of the listings here on eBay, again, that $100 and under price point, you can definitely pick up some decent priced cards on the market, especially if you're looking to build a sub $300 or $400 gaming PC, then this is the most critical element right there, and it's available and ready to ship. Then the next line of graphics cards I'm going to draw attention to is something like an RX 470 4GB. Now, if you're looking for the 8GB cards, especially when it comes to an RX 580 or an RX 470, these miners, the cryptocurrency miners, are just gonna snap those cards up straight away because they're still very profitable for mining what's known as Ethereum. And even though there are other altcoins out there that are profitable, most cryptocurrency miners that are serious about putting a lot of money into cryptocurrency mining are definitely looking at the Ethereum profits, because that is the main player in town when it comes to mining and also mining profitability. That being said though, the RX 470 4GB, and even if you look for something like an RX 5500 XT 4GB, these graphics cards, at least in the pure essence from miners, they're not as targeted as they would be by the people looking for the 8GB cards. So your 4GB and under graphics cards, at least when you're getting into the newer cards, even though these cards are still a few years old, you can still pick up here or there, if you're quick enough, a good deal on some of these graphics cards. Though going back to the Nvidia side of things, there are a few more cards that I do look for, although I'm finding I'm not having as much success as the older cards, at least when it comes to value for money. Though that being said, I'm always on the lookout for a GTX 970 or a GTX 980. These cards can still give out really good performance for the dollar, and you can pick them up on the used market for what I consider a pretty decent price. For instance, in Australia, I can pick up one of these cards locally from time to time, a GTX 970, for $150, even though previously I was paying around $120 for one. Also looking at the GTX 10 series, when it comes to that, I'm looking heavily at GTX 1050 Ti's and GTX 1050s, 4GB and 2GB cards, as they remain under that 4GB buffer, but also their crypto mining performance isn't that great, which means I can snag them up and put together gaming PCs for pretty good prices. Though there's also the GTX 1060 3GB. However, I have been finding that a few people, at least cryptocurrency miners, are targeting, believe it or not, the GTX 1060 3GB. Whenever they see these up for a decent price, they go snag them up and then start mining what is known as altcoins. So quickly summing things up, as it stands, with the market, especially the used GPU market. And if you're looking to build a gaming PC, your best bet right now, at least to get the best price performance or the best frame for your dollar, is to buy the more inefficient cards that burn up a bit more power and have lower VRAM sizes, mainly 4 gigabytes and under, as these cards are really not worth it for miners, where they have to put them on a system and pay for expensive power supplies. And as they add up all those costs, those older cards that are more inefficient just don't make any sense to them. Though the final thing to talk about in the land of graphics cards, and the reason why I think a lot of frustration is starting to seep in, at least when it comes to PC gaming that exists this time, that actually didn't exist in 2017 and 2018 when there was the previous crypto boom, is that Nvidia and AMD are simply not releasing lower budget cards that were represented really good price performance. And these were the graphics cards that the majority of gamers were buying. If we look at the Steam surveys, the GTX 1060 is still the most popular dedicated graphics card used by gamers. And so what this meant was that cards that came in around $200 and under, and they offered really good price performance, were the cards that gamers wanted to snap up and put in their gaming rigs. And unfortunately, when we look in 2021, what AMD and Nvidia are doing, they're just simply not releasing any successes to the GTX 1060 or the RX 580. I mean, AMD did release the RX 5500 XT, the 4 gigabyte, and the 8 gigabyte, which had MSRPs of $200 and under, but I simply did not see hardly any stock of these cards sold in Australia. I'm not too sure about Europe and also America, but the RX 5500 XT, it only offered slightly more performance than the RX 570 and 580. If we go over to Nvidia's side of the camp, the GTX 1660 Super and also the GTX 1650 Super, these were cards that were released now nearly 2 years ago, and they were offering a bump up in performance over the 1050 and also the 1060 respectively. However, we're yet to see Nvidia at least put these cards back on the market in bulk or release a successor to them. And I think that right there is why not only the higher end market for RX 6700 XTs and RTX 3070s are experiencing bad pricing from crypto miners, but there's also this massive demand from gamers that has always been there, and Nvidia and AMD are not providing the supply on the lower end. Anyhow, guys, do let us know what you think of today's video. If you want to get some graphics cards at decent prices, I'll put some of my searches in the description below. But also, we do have Intel with their ARC announcement. If you guys want a dedicated video on that, and perhaps we can mix the ways to get a decent price on a new graphics card in one video, I can make that happen for you. And as always, love reading your thoughts and opinions, just like this question of the day here. And this comes from Jason Frederick, and they ask, how do the fans survive the bath without removing the lube in the bearings? And they're referring to our recent episode of PC Ultra Clean. I'll put the link to that video up here, where we give these parts a massive clean from start to finish. But the main star of the show is the ultrasonic cleaner, which I just pretty much dip into hot tap water with detergent, and the ultrasonic cleaner does the rest. And in the process, technically, if there's things like lube in fans, they should come out. But every time I've cleaned fans in this ultrasonic cleaner, the fans have been fine afterward, which means to me that the seals are holding up very well in these fans. However, in the past, I have come into noisy fans, and it depends on the noise. If it's like a new graphics card and it's got a little bit of a noise on it, sometimes I'll just put some multi-purpose spray on there, grease it up a little bit. But if it's a little bit of a heavier knock on the fan, I'll just use some of this degreaser. And this stuff's a little bit thicker than WD-40 or multi-purpose spray, and then that usually the noise goes away after that. So that's what I do personally. I just haven't come into any knocking fans after I've washed them, surprisingly. Actually, now that I think about it, probably is a little bit surprising, but I guess it's a testament to all the fans that have gone through the ultrasonic cleaner and that they haven't broken their seals for the lubrication. Hope that answers that question. And with that aside, if you guys have stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell to get the content as soon as it drops here. And I'll see you next time. Peace out for now. Bye.